Hello children, connecting to my previous video, today we are going to study algebraic identities and the examples based on them. So my first identity, it is a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. In my previous video I have explained you how we are getting this expansion. So here is our second identity, a minus b whole square, it is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. And our third identity and second identity, many children get confused by that. Why? I don't understand. Here is a square minus b square and its expansion is a plus b into a minus b. When you do the binomial multiplication here, you will get the answer as a square minus b square. Many children, whenever I say a square minus b square, they will give me the answer a square minus b square minus 2ab. But there is no identity with that name. When a minus b whole square, you should read this as whole square. Then when you read a minus b whole square, it is a square plus b square minus 2ab. In both the cases, a square plus b square only is there, children. Don't get confused. When there is a question a square minus b square, then you have to apply this identity as a plus b into a minus b. I think in your first chapter, real numbers also, you have applied this for rationalizing the denominator. So my fourth identity is x plus a and x plus b. What is the difference between x plus b and a plus b whole square? Means here it can be written as a plus b into a plus b. But here it is x plus a and x plus b. There are three unknown terms. Can you observe? One is x, another is a, another is b. Whereas here only two unknown terms, hence we will take first identity when there is two unknown terms. When there is three unknown terms, a may be a constant also. Here also b may be a constant also. Any one variable will be there and another may be a constant also. Not all the time, all the both are constants. Okay children, don't get confused with this formula and this formula. Here this formula will become equal to this formula when a and b both are same. That is x plus a equal to into x plus a. These both are same means I can write it as x plus a whole square, whereas here a is different, b is different. Henceforth I can't apply this first identity for the fourth identity. So the solution for x plus a into x plus b is we should take first term x and multiply with the second bracket x. So x square plus, when you multiply x into b, and here when you multiply a into x, in both the cases we will get x as common, hence a plus b into x. I am writing directly. Next we will multiply a into b, binomial multiplication children. So I am getting my fourth identity. So based on these four identities only, today I am going to solve few examples. So you have to copy those examples in your notes from the textbook or from the board directly, children. So now you have to find the products of the following using appropriate identities. First you have to choose the identity and then solve the sum here. So your question is x plus 3, x plus 3. As soon as you see this question, many children will say x plus a, x plus b identity. But observe carefully, children. Here also 3, here also 3. Means only two unknown factors are there. That is, one is x and another is 3. Hence, I can write this as x plus 3 whole square, isn't it? So, now which identity will be applicable? Our first identity, that is a plus b whole square. You can directly copy from the board in your notes, children. A square plus 2ab plus b square. Now what is a here? A is equal to x. b is equal to 3. So here wherever there is a, I can write as x. Wherever there is b, I will write as 3 plus 3 square. Okay. Now x square plus bracket is nothing but multiplication. 2, 3 is 6x plus 9. This is your answer. So your second question. There are 3 unknown facts. One is x, another is 3, another is 5. But we have given the formula for x plus a, x plus b. Hence, I should take a as minus 3 and b as plus 5. Okay. This is same as x plus a and x plus b, fourth identity. Same as your fourth identity I have written here. Now, x equal to x only here. A equal to minus 3, b equal to 5, plus 5. So, I should substitute here. X square, a is equal to minus 3, b is equal to plus 5, and x as it is, and minus 3 into plus 5. So, in 5, if we subtract 3, we will get 2. Hence, it is positive 2x, and plus into minus is minus, 5, 3 is 15. This is your solution. So, your next example 17 question is, evaluate 106 into 107 without multiplying directly. Means, you should use the identity here and then multiply children. I will show you how to split this first. So, begin your solution like this. First, you write 106 into 107. 106 is nothing but 100 plus 6. Okay. And into 100 plus 7. Now here 100 is common in both the boxes, in both the brackets, 6 here and 7 here. So I can choose the fourth identity x plus a into x plus b as there are different 6 and 7. So x is 100, a is 6, b is 7. Now, what is the solution for this identity? X square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Now, what is x? 100. So, 100 square plus a plus b means 6 plus 7. X means again 100 plus a into b means 6 into 7. Now, 100 square is nothing but 10,000. 13 into 100 plus 42. So, now in next step, 13 into 100 is 1300 and add all the other numbers. So, now this is your solution, children. So, if I change the numbers here as 106 and 105, what will be your solution? I think this question is 106 and 105. Change this question, practice and give me the answer later. Okay, children, will you try at home? Okay. So, your example 18 is factorize. Factorize is nothing but, already the expansion will be given here, children. So, this matches to which identity you have to find out and write the identity. That's all. So, first of all, we should write 49. Whose square is 49? We know that 49 is a square of 7. Henceforth, I can write this as 7a whole square plus, here again, 25 I know as 5b whole square. So, according to me, a is 7a, b is 5b. Hence, I can write this as 2ab, that is 7a and 5b. So, this matches our identity, a square plus 2ab plus b square. That is, I am going to write here, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Hence, my identity is a plus b whole square, where a equal to 7a and b equal to 5b. Hence, therefore, a plus b whole square means 7a plus 5b whole square. As it is whole square, I can write this bracket two times. That is 7a plus 5b into 7a plus 5b. This is the solution. If you have not understood, you can call me children. I will explain once again for you. Okay, kindly copy this in your notes directly. Okay, this is a question about a binomial. Seeing this binomial only, you will understand that Hoye, this is third identity. 25, whose square is 25? 5 square. 5 by 2, x whole square minus y by 3 whole square. So, this resembles my identity a square minus b square. Henceforth, solution is a plus b into a minus b, where a equal to 5 by 2 x and b equal to y by 3. Okay, now wherever there is a, I should write 5 by 2 x. Wherever there is b, I should write y by 3. So now this is the solution, children. Kindly copy in your notes. Okay, thank you, children. Thanks for watching the video.